Aero is Adobe's new app that has huge potential to bring AR authoring to the masses. Let's take a look at what it can do. Adobe Aero is currently available for free on iPadOS and is in private beta for desktop. Let's create a new project. When we start, we've got a view from our iPad camera and it prompts us to scan our area. And we can see it's adding tracking markers and looking for a surface to plant our AR objects. It's picked up my desktop pretty quickly. So let's tap on this pin here to make this our work area. Now we can add an object by clicking plus in the bottom left. Let's choose from our starter assets. Let's select from plants and this pine tree. Now we can see it here, and let's just tap to place it on the desk. Now we can see when we move the iPad around, this is tracked pretty nicely. This is actually really good. And there's a lot of detail in the texture here as well. We can even zoom in really close and even get inside the object. If we tap on that object, we select it, and with a two-finger pinch, we can scale it down or rotate it. And with a three-finger swipe up, we can lift it off that plane. Now this level of tracking is pretty incredible. I'm by no means a tracking expert, but I've been using After Effects for a while and I've used Mocha for some planar tracking. And this level of speed and fidelity in motion tracking is really something. And from here, we can add a behavior to this object by selecting it. And down here, we can click behaviors and add a trigger to make this object interactive. Let's make it interact on touch. And now we need to add an action. And here we've got some choices of actions we can take. I'm gonna select spin, and we can choose, it can spin on its y-axis. And we've got a lot of options down here. And we can preview it with this play button. That looks pretty good. And let's click tick. Now object is interactive. If we go up to the top left and click preview, we can preview our scene. It brings up this record option here, so we could record this and save this to our camera roll if we like. And if we tap on the tree, it spins. You can also add custom animations to your behaviors as well. Let's go back to our edit window, select this pine tree and delete it. Now let's add another object from our starter assets and choose an animated one. And let's select our fox hopping. Put our fox down here. Let's scale this down pretty small. And now we're gonna select it, add the behavior, trigger on touch. We're gonna add the action animate. This fox asset that provided already has an animation built in. So let's click the tick to add it. Go up to our preview and let's click the fox. Now this one is incredible. The tracking is great, but the character design and animation of this fox is exceptional. I can really see so many possibilities for this technology in the future. Maybe a horror game in your own house where spooky things happen in your peripherals. That idea is a very sort of basic application that comes to mind trying to apply this to existing genres, but I'm sure there will be new AR mediums for education and entertainment that haven't even been imagined yet. You can also add your own elements by selecting them from your files or camera roll. Here are my logos. You can see there's a bit of artifacting happening and making the edges of this logo look a bit crispy on the alpha channel. And this is a high-res PNG, so I'm not exactly sure if that's, you know, avoidable. You can also import a layered PSD and it will separate the layers automatically. And if we select on it and click layers down here, we have some more options where we can offset it in Z space and even on the Y and X axes as well. You can also add your 3D objects. OBJs work and Adobe lists some more file types, so it shouldn't be too tricky to get your 3D files into here. While we're in our preview mode, we can click on the top right and there we have options to share a link or export as a .real, .reality, or a .usdz. There's not much documentation from Adobe about this software so far, so please let me know if you'd like me to continue exploring what Aero can do and put out some more videos about AR.
I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.